Everybody wants a big chest and big arms. You don't have to nag people to do bench press or bicep curls. Many people, though, neglect legs, thinking they can just wear long pants their whole life long. But this is a big mistake, because someday it's going to be so hot that they're going to have to wear short pants. And when they do...
Chicken legs. He's going to tip over. He's more top-heavy than Dolly Parton.
It's tough to find safe, effective quad exercises to do at home because they're such big muscles and they're so strong that body weight exercises just won't do it. Squats are great for quads, but they are not safe to do at home, in my opinion, unless you have two spotters. And very few people have two spotters. This is a Scooby's Workshop exclusive. This is my favorite quad exercise you can do at home. You're going to need a skateboard for this. This is a $19 cheapo skateboard. It's perfect for what we're going to do. And we need a stool that is as tall as our knees. What we're going to do, the stool is going to limit our range of motion so that our bottom doesn't go below our knees. And this keeps the angle to 90 degrees. And the skateboard is going to go behind our back, which is going to allow us to smoothly slide up and down without friction. Now you'll notice this motion is very similar to a hack squat machine at the gym, and it's one you can do at home. Now, that's not very much resistance. That's not going to do you any good. But the easy thing is, you just get your set of dumbbells that you have, and you can use any weight you want, and then you have the resistance. And it's safely limits your range of motion. Now let's look at some form things here. You choose the stool height so that when you're down, your knee is 90 degrees, no more. You don't want your bottom so low that your knee is cramped up like that, because that puts a lot of stress on your knee and doesn't give you any more effect in your quads. Also, you need to watch where your toes are. You don't want your knee past your toe. At most, you want your knee even with your toe, like this. It's okay if your toes are a little further out, but they can't be further behind your knees. So again, here's what it looks like. Grab the dumbbells. Oh, that feels good. Now, an important point here. I'm putting a lot of weight against this wall, so you can't do this indoors with a plaster wall. You need a really solid wall, either wood or masonry. Otherwise, you're going to take these skate wheels and punch them right through the wall, and you wouldn't be very popular with mom with that. Okay, some more points on form. We're going to try to do these really slowly. Try to do 1 to 2 seconds up and 1 to 2 seconds down. Also, no bouncing on the stool. It's just there for safety. When you go down, just touch it lightly. Now let's talk about foot position. Some people you say you should point your toes in like a pigeon. Some say you should point them out. I say use a natural stance. We want to minimize the stress on the knee joint, so stand naturally and then look down at your feet. That's how I think they should be angled when you do this skateboard squat. The quads are really strong muscles, and you may find that the dumbbells you're using are very heavy, and you might need to use wrist straps so that you can hold them long enough. Don't be dropping the weights. I know I harp on this a lot, but it's really important that you keep everything in balance. You do upper body and legs. And when you do legs, you do quads and you do hamstrings. Big quads and teensy little hamstrings not only look stupid, but it's really bad for your knee joints. So, don't let the gnomes laugh at you. Make sure to work out your quads and your hamstrings.